We finally have real data on how AI will transform the future of work. The biggest and the most comprehensive study was just released by Harvard Business School that explored the effects of AI on knowledge worker productivity, and the results are not as simple as you might expect. So in this video, let's dive deeper into this paper together and explore how you can adapt to these rapid changes. I will also be sharing some extra tips and prompt examples that personally worked for me at the end. Let's begin. The setup of this paper is quite interesting. It involved 758 consultants at Boston Consulting Group, where participants were allocated to one of three groups to measure AI's influence. A control group, one with GPT-4 assistance, and another with GPT-4 plus additional training material. However, what makes this paper actually noteworthy is that they were assigned to one of two types of tasks, either innovation-focused tasks or strategy-focused tasks. And the numbers are quite shocking. Consultants who used GPT-4 outperformed those who did not on every dimension. They completed 12% more tasks on average, finished tasks 25% more quickly, and produced 40% higher quality results, okay? This is not something you can typically achieve within a day. That's a difference between a junior and a senior consultant. And as you might expect, those who were briefly introduced to AI did even better. But there was a catch. On tasks that were outside the capabilities of AI, consultants who used AI actually performed worse. They got the problem right 80% of the time without AI, but when they used AI, their accuracy actually dropped to 60-70%. So why is this happening? Well, as authors suggest, there is an invisible wall of AI capabilities, where tasks within this wall are performed exceptionally well by AI, and tasks outside of it, AI can't handle at all. The problem is, however, is that it's not a straight line, but rather a jagged edge with peaks and valleys that authors call the jagged technological frontier. We have to understand where this wall lies in order to effectively use AI. Otherwise, we might run into issues. I personally analyzed all the tasks from this paper using GPT-4, so here's what it said makes them distinct. The tasks inside the frontier are micro-level, meaning that they focus on details like product features, when tasks outside the frontier are macro-level. They are strategy-focused and require external data to complete them. So if you think about it, this makes perfect sense, because in tasks that involve strategy work, there are often no right or wrong answers. They require a lot more context, and sometimes it's not even possible to put it all in words. You can't assign AI to create a strategy for a company without considering all the recent events and market conditions, leave alone the company's culture, values, and long-term vision. And falling into this trap of over-reliance on AI is extremely easy, unless, as authors suggest, you follow one of the two approaches. As a matter of fact, there were also a lot of consultants who did get both inside and outside the frontier tasks right. They got all the advantages of using AI without any disadvantages. So how did they do this? Well, it seems that the secret is in using AI in one of two ways, either as a cyborg or as a centaur. Essentially, centaur practices involve splitting tasks between human and AI based on their respective strengths. For example, as a centaur, you may rely on AI for text refinement and switch to your own analysis for generating recommendations. Cyborg practices, on the other hand, involve combining human and AI efforts. In this approach, it can be hard to tell if the result was created by a person or an AI. Both practices help you navigate the jagged technological frontier effectively. So it doesn't even matter which approach you select, rather it is important that you know the strengths and weaknesses of AI. I will provide some tips at the end for how to leverage both approaches. But for now, let's see what it means for the future of work. In a follow-up article, Everyone is Above Average, one of the authors makes a point that AI acts essentially as an equalizer. Most professions nowadays require multiple skills across various areas to become a top performer. For example, someone might be extremely good at programming, but not so good at pitching ideas. AI, however, can help balance out those weaknesses. It can fill in your weak points, making you better at tasks that you're not naturally good at. In fact, Three additional studies have shown extremely similar results. A study from MIT showed that using ChatGPT reduced the performance gap between good and bad writers by half. Another study showed that law students at the bottom of their class improved their performance to match the top students when using GPT-4. And a real-world experiment found that AI improved the performance of low-performing customer service agents but had almost no effects on high-performing agents. So, what does it mean for hiring? Well, if AI can help less skilled workers catch up with their more skilled counterparts, then it might make sense to hire less skilled workers and train them to use AI instead. Additionally, solopreneurs and freelancers could become more powerful than ever. They could potentially compete with entire companies because they would be able to perform a much wider range of tasks. And finally, although authors say that it will not lead to job replacement because everyone will just focus on higher value tasks, which is a common argument that we often hear, I disagree with this opinion. This is nothing like humanity has ever experienced before. Even during the Industrial Revolution, it took workers years to learn how to use machines and increase their productivity. Now, this transformation happens within a single day. So I personally think that because AI is advancing at a much faster pace than what anybody expected, until the world adapts, some people might lose jobs. Feel free to disagree with my opinion in the comments. I'll try to answer every single one. Finally, let me share with you my personal experience of how I use AI as an AI consultant. You see, I wasn't born special. I worked as a freelancer just a half a year ago, and now I'm managing a team of 7 people because after I bought a ChatGPT Plus subscription for myself, I was able to handle more clients than ever before. But perhaps the secret to my success with AI lies in the fact that I had experience working with large language models. What you need to know is that ChatGPT is essentially the whole internet compressed. If you just ask it to do something for you without any context, you will get the most average result on the internet possible. If Shakespeare were using AI in this way, there would be no Shakespeare. So personally, mostly I adopt the cyborg approach. I constantly switch back and forth from AI to human mode. So, for example, if I'm writing a report, I might ask it a few questions, like what are the key points to consider regarding the strategy plan for AI adoption in this particular company. Then I usually ask it multiple times again, what else, until it gives me so many points to consider that at least a few of them start to click in my own mind. I can then pick the best ones and compile them together with my own sources into a first draft. Then I will ask it for some feedback. I will never just say improve my report because I have no idea to what standard it will improve it. Instead, I will look at the feedback and decide if I want to listen to it. On the other hand, if I'm using a Centaur approach, my favorite prompt is ask me questions until you have enough information and then you insert the task. So for the same report, the prompt could be ask me questions until you have enough information to create a strategy plan for this company's AI implementation. Then ChatGPT will usually ask me around 10 questions, which are hard to answer, and even just thinking about them is already extremely useful. But after I answer them, that's when the real magic happens. Now ChatGPT is not like a child that just woke up and has no memory whatsoever about what's going on. It also has your knowledge and your context. This actually allows it to come up with something useful and unique, tailored to your specific situation. So definitely try both approaches and let me know in the comments if you're a Centaur or a Cyborg, and if you want to see more videos on ChatGPT productivity. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.